Under delegated authority from the President, the Minister of Finance, Matia Kasaija, will deliver the budget speech, breaking down how the 52 trillion shillings for the financial year 2023-2024 will be put to action. We bring you the highlights of the 2023-2024 financial year budget. Much as the overall budget was increased by 4.6 trillion shillings to 52 trillion shillings compared with the current financial year budget, the actual discretionary resource available for distribution to entities has reduced by 240 billion shillings. This has been attributed to the increase in interest payment from 4.69 trillion shillings to 6.1 trillion shillings, Bank of Uganda reimbursements at 1.5 trillion shillings, and Bank of Uganda recapitalization at 217.3 billion shillings.
But having the budget implemented in the way we expect is another thing. I say so because I've seen situations where Parliament has passed the budget and within 3 months you hear that Minister of Finance has suppressed the budget. You hear that the budget cuts have been implemented. Somebody's budget has been cut by 80%. So passing this budget is one thing. But the other thing is, will the money be released?
More in a common man's understanding, the budget does not actually mean the money allocated at the end of the day is going to reach the intended beneficiaries. So it is more of a blank budget.
The budget is to be financed as follows: through domestic revenue projected at 29.67 trillion shillings, budget support, grants and loans, 2.78 trillion shillings, domestic borrowing, 3.38 trillion shillings, domestic debit refinancing at 8.36 trillion shillings, project support, external financing at 8.26 trillion shillings, and local government revenue projected at 287.1 billion shillings. Of the 52 trillion shillings budget, 27.58 trillion shillings will take the first call on the budget to meet government commitments to debt repayment. Only 25.16 trillion shillings remains for distribution to government entities for the financial year 2023-2024 towards statutory obligations, development expenditure, among other priorities.
Now, government is paying the 200 billion because that's the money that's available. And I request some patience on this as government tries to sort it out.
However, some members of parliament are skeptical that budget allocations are still incentive priorities of public and it will be a tall order to realize its achievements.
The value addition that the president has always talked about should be put in action. It shouldn't remain in words. How can we talk about value addition when we're not putting money in value addition? I'm already worried.
It is an assumption. Supplementary budgets are going to come up from the office of the presidency, classified, and other dockets whereby money is supposed to be used on expenditure or expenditure that is luxurious, that is not intended to benefit the common Ugandans.
The 2023-2024 financial year budget is prepared under the theme Full Monetization of the Economy Through Commercial Agriculture, Industrialization, Expanding and Broadening Services, Digital Transformation and Market Access.
Homesteads from subsistence farming.
Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.